very little done.
Now just stop, rewind, Mr. Webb, and just let everyone in here know the jobs I've done for you today.
Yes.
I have hardly stood a think hard now. So there's times when you think, why do I bother getting out of bed in the morning, really, to get here on time?
Yeah,
you
know what
I
mean?
And I got here on time, gentlemen, I got here on time this morning. I was banging on the door, phoning him, open the fucking door.
I was only downstairs.
I was going to go home and leave a note on the
door
saying,
exactly,
I was here.
What I was doing this morning.
Yeah, having a shit, Paul.
Misery is rushing down on me like a landslide.
I looked and I thought, recycling records? He said no, recycling sound. We ended up with circular sound because the CD, the record, the audio tape, the DVD, they all go round in a circle. If you googled circular sound, only two companies will come up in the UK, me and the other company is a company that looks after hearing aids. So yeah, if you want a hearing aid after you've listened to all the music I sell you, you can still go to another company called Circular Sound. How about that? Right.
Bigger at the top.
Yeah, that's about right, I think.
Circular Sound, good morning. Oh, hi, yeah. What email address have you got that you're sending the to and from? Is that the same as what I sent you?
There's three. Chaps that helped me. Two are called Steve.
Well, at home I've got quite a large record collection, probably running to about 20,000 units. Having one room just dedicated to vinyl, racked floor to ceiling, is probably not that usual, I know, but there you go. Got to keep it somewhere.
If you go that way, because I'm doing this.
Okay.
Yeah, and I want to chat with this gentleman.
It's a bit crammed, but anyway, we'll find out. Follow me. You have to tread carefully. Be really careful because there's not a lot of space on the stairs. I'll let you make your way down in your own time. John and I actually spent a whole day clearing. We had these doors open. We actually fought a way to the doors. We managed to clear this entrance here to the doors. We managed to get the doors open. This was last summer, Joe. We got the doors open and we were able to clear this whole aisle out, the central aisle, so you could get up and down there. Within a week, it stacked everything up and it had all gone back again. It's like one step forward, two steps back. It's a bit soul-destroying, really. Yeah. A bit of a futile exercise, but there you go. Steve and I go back a long way from sort of 20 years ago when Martin had the secondhand stall down in the indoor market, and Steve had a hemp stall, and things weren't going too well, so I think he sold up and started working for Martin.
How are you doing, Steve?
I'm fine, thanks, mate. Yeah, I'm all right. Pissed off with Martin, just moaning at me all bleeding day, but there you go. Steve and I are very close friends. He just lives about 100 yards from me, up around the corner from where I live. I go around his, he comes around mine, and we sort of swap music.
My problem is now, I never know if I've got them or not, especially with certain artists.
I'm Steve. I've been kind of known Martin for nearly 20 years, I guess. Also known Steve for about that time as well. I have other jobs, you know, and I do them, and then I always come back. It's like a weird kind of magnet, you know, you just sort of keep coming back. I always kind of end up coming back to Martin.
Here he is.
Good afternoon, again.
Hello, John, you're all right?
Here we are.
John and I have a similar interest in Northern Soul and 60s music.
Well, I've always collected music ever since I was 16, because I never had a radio until I was 16 anyway, so that's the only reason. Well, I sort of think back, well, that one's a good one. That one was only issued on 12 inches, so that sort of thing. Hey, you got a copy? No, I sold all mine.
I used to be innocent and naive before I started working here. Now I'm just a...
Just naive.
John, I've only known recently. He used to come up to the Northern Soul Nights that Martin did.
The other two Steves, oh, they're great lads. They're great. We all have a good old bit of banter between us, you know, get through the day sort of thing.
The new Blancmange album, Commuter 23, that's a masterpiece. Okay. Awesome. It's really, really good. It's quite ambient, it's quite slow, but everything, it just hits you in the face.
We went into a charity shop on Magdalen Street just before Christmas. Walked in there, couldn't believe it. Somebody had dumped a load of psych and prog. Rare stuff in there. And yeah, we were like salivating and we're looking at each other going, holy fuck.
That probably was the result of somebody passing away who was, you know, seriously into their music, and perhaps their spouse or whatever, or they didn't have anybody, you know, to any dependents. And the contents of their house probably just ended up in a charity shop, and they just happened to have bought a load of prog and psych in their lifetime. Yeah. But it's onto a good home. I go to bed at night just going 4818, 4817, 4815. I've made a lot of friends from working in the shop. I can't keep away from the place, so I come in on Saturdays and help out because I'm in that environment where, you know, I'm with like-minded customers and just in amongst music, which suits me fine.
Right, see you guys later.
Bye, John. Take care. Yeah. Yeah. You know how to get there, don't you?
Yeah, by car.
Yeah, thank you.
It's more than a kind of record shop in the way that it's, you know, you kind of... We just go there to hang out. I would say that music is the underlying thing, but actually, beyond that now, friendship has become more stronger than the music, even.
Oh, have a good one.
Okay.
Cool. See you later.
Just see you.
We've just become really good friends, really, through the music. And again, I've made a lot of friends outside of the shop from them having been customers in the shop and coming in. And, you know, sort of like having mutual interests and sort of, you know, go for a drink and get to know each other a bit better over music, which is good.
Is that the only thing that makes it bearable in here, Joe, is the banter?
Thank you, darling.
You're welcome, sweetheart.
We are first and foremost friends, and then after that, their staff.
People come into the shop and it's amazing. You just see two complete strangers meeting in the shop for the first time. One overhears something, they join in the conversation, and they're there for the next hour chatting to each other about music, and friendships are formed in the shop, you know, and that's a nice thing.
Have a good night tonight, mate.
Thank you.
Hope it goes well for you.
Cheers. We're all in good hands.
I'm sure. Yeah, it's good. Bye, Joe.
Have a good one.
Bye.
See ya.
Bye.
I've got all these trophies because I've killed all these things. Is it as native as that? Mm. You know, they would have their trophies after, wouldn't they? They'd have all the antlers up of the animals or the hooves. They'd collect a little part and keep... a part of the animal to say that they've done it, and you become the, not necessarily the king, but the leader by how good you were sometimes at getting that job done and feeding the tribe.
And seasons all but fade away into misty clouds of autumn gray. As I sit here looking at the street, little figures quickly moving feet,